So when you think of lavender, what do you think of? Provence.
France.
Not Spain. We're in a little town called Brihuega, about an hour and 5 minutes from Madrid, northeast. And these are the famous lavender fields of Brihuega. And they use it to make perfumes, soaps, all kinds of things. The 16th of July, every summer, they have the Fiesta of the Lavender. So we've come out here to have a little look at it and try not get sunburned. So it's a summer crop. We're towards the end of it here, so it's not quite maybe as purple as it might be. But back there, there's a car park. It's quite well set up. And there's lots of people taking photos. So we've moved a bit further in to take our photos. And after we see this, we're gonna head to one of the pueblos nearby. After doing the traveling, we're gonna do some gastro. There you go. So we've chosen one field, but apparently there's more than 1,000 hectares of lavender here. This is not 1,000, but you can see how far it stretches. And we've already seen a couple of rows have started to be cut. So I presume we're towards the end of the flowering and towards the harvest, which is nice. We are also mostly surrounded by it, and we've been doing it as well, to be fair. People taking photos. This is catnip for influencers. There's also lots of sunflowers around here. We're in the pueblecito of Villaviciosa de Tajuña, the vicious village of the Tajuña River, trying to find some food. They have a thing called the Casa de Comidas, which is like a big, I think it's like a set menu prepared thing, as opposed to like a restaurant with a long menu. I'm gonna see if we can get some grub, and then we're gonna carry on to the town of Brihuega. So it's a fixed menu, just been told. I won't say the price, 25 euros. And it's 5 courses, 4 savory and 1 sweet. Don't know what's gonna happen. We have the olive oil. The rest is gonna be a voyage of discovery. So the first course is a watermelon gazpacho with what they call jamon powder and a slice of parsley. It's really nice. Mmm.
Fresquito.
It's super fresquito. Ah, gracias. Mira tu clarita con limón. So loud. This was a empanada of morcilla black pudding and roasted pine nuts. And is that pineapple? From the Azores. Azores. Interesting. Morcilla, yes. Pineapple, don't know yet. But it's good.
No,
salty cheesecake.
No.
Después de todo eso.
There's cheese.
Whoa. Pork knuckle. Cooked overnight. Tradicional cocina nocturna. On rosemary potatoes. Come on, look at the meat. Go in there. Meat. I don't understand vegetarians.
A sponge cake of carrot on a base of yogurt topped with cheese. It's carrot cake.
Mmm.
Moist.
So we've come out to the village of Brihuega. It's so busy. It took us about 5 days to find a place to park. We've now parked 3 towns away, it feels like. But anyway, we're arriving at the capital of the lavender, and it's all lavender themed, which is quite cool. Lavender ice cream. Can we have it with honey or chocolate? We're going for the pure one.
that's good.
It's almost citrusy, got like citrusy.
Little stalls selling lavender beer, lavender food, fabrics, t-shirts, everything related to lavender. It's very impressive.
It's really warm, as well as lavender things. Brihuega is actually quite a cute town, so we're going to check out a few of the old buildings before we head back.
Escaping the heat in the car from Brihuega. Amazing little town, amazing to see the lavender fiesta still going with all the colours and things. And the lavender ice cream was very nice. The lavender in English. Anyway, on our way back to Madrid now, so of course, liking and subscribing if you want. If you don't, then you know, screw you guys, but you should really. And anyway, see you at the next one.
Bye.